Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup. And in this last supplementary dissection video for the anterior neck and thorax, we're going to have kind of a smattering of different structures that we want to talk about. So we're going to start with some of the viscera that we can see, specifically some viscera we can see in what's called the anterior cervical triangle. So we'll start with that, and then we'll kind of ID how we're going to label and figure out this triangle. All right, so let's start with the thyroid gland, and let's kind of get our bearings in terms of some of the other pertinent structures. So you'll have the carotid sheath contents over here laterally on both sides. You can see a bit of the thyroid cartilage right here. The hyoid bone would be up in this region. The trachea is going to be deep. And then right in this region here, you'll have a fairly dominant kind of butterfly-shaped structure called the thyroid gland. And this is that largest endocrine gland. As we discussed, there will be two lobes. You'll have a left and a right lobe. So both of these are going to be considered lobes, and they are connected by this midline and kind of pinched-in area called the isthmus. Now, the parathyroid glands can be found in a variety of locations, but its most typical location is on the posterior aspect of the thyroid gland. So in this image, all the strap muscles, as well as the sternocleidomastoid, have been reflected superiorly, and that really allows us to better be able to see the thyroid gland. On this side, on the right side, the thyroid gland has not been reflected. You can see the trachea right here. But on this side, the thyroid gland has been reflected, and we're looking at a posterior view of the thyroid gland. And I hope you notice these fairly distinct structures that not every time look as distinct as these two do. And these are examples of parathyroid glands. There are typically four parathyroid glands. There's usually a superior pair, so there'd be a superior one over here. To match this one, and then an inferior pair if we were looking at the posterior side of the thyroid gland right here. The superior pair is typically the most constant in size and placement. The inferior pair is the one that could be in different locations. And I said that the thyroid gland is actually located in the anterior cervical triangle. And a triangle and other structures like this are means by which clinicians and healthcare teams can describe an area without having to say all the boundaries. So if we all have an understanding of where the anterior cervical triangle is, you don't have to explain, well, you know, it's kind of below the mandible, but you know, away from the sternocleidomastoid or the sternum. It's a bit more precise in terms of its descriptions. And so the anterior cervical triangle is a fairly large area. Its boundaries are going to include, its medial boundary will be the midline, which is what we have right here. The superior boundary will be the base of the mandible, or the bottom of that lower jaw region. And then the lateral boundary will be the anterior border of the sternocleidomastoid, which is an easily palpable location or landmark of the neck. So that can give you a good idea of where the anterior cervical triangle is. The posterior cervical triangle will be back in this region. So there's lots located in the anterior cervical triangle, and you'll have a matching one on the right side as well. So it would be right here. So you'll have two anterior cervical triangles. You'll have glands in this region, so that thyroid and parathyroid glands are going to be deep, but still within the anterior cervical triangle. You'll also have the submandibular glands, which are salivary glands. Carotid sheath in its contents, so those large neurovascular structures. You'll have muscles, of course. And then you'll even have the larynx that's going to be associated with this, and portions of the trachea. All right, excellent. So those are the structures that you need to be able to identify and understand those pertinent anatomical relationships for this particular session. Anything that is on the list of structures is fair game for a practical assessment. So make sure that you review these, get a good idea of how you're going to be able to identify them. And if there's any areas that need further clarification, always feel free to reach out to me or any of my anatomy colleagues. We love talking anatomy and we love talking to you students. Thanks for your time and attention, and have a great day.